What's in season? What's in season? What's in season? I hear you ask.
Peaches, everybody. Hello, and welcome back to What's in Season? I hear you ask. I've got the window open because we are in summer and it's a little bit of a breeze today. So if you hear my galangal on the magic windowsill rattling, that's why it's rattling. So today I am going to do a recipe with peaches. Unfortunately, I didn't grow them, but I did get these fantastic peaches from our local farm shop. Went in the other day and they have been ripening beautifully. They were already kind of ripe and they have been ripening beautifully on my table, and they just smell absolutely divine. I'm just going to put that aside here for a minute. All right, there are a million recipes you can make with peaches. So I thought a sundae, too easy. Should we do a crumble? Too easy. And then I thought to myself, honestly, there's nothing better than a pie, don't you think? So I am going to make a peach pie. There we are. The first thing I have to get on with is making my pastry. And this is actually a really, really easy recipe to make for a flaky pastry, which is absolutely delicious. And you can use it as your stock standard pie pastry for anything, really. You know, we're coming now, we're mid-summery, we're in August at the moment, and as we get towards the autumn, we're getting things like all the stoned fruits, peaches, plums, all of that type of thing are coming on board. And apples. But let's get on with it. All right, this recipe. I used to make my doughs for pies in the food processor. I don't anymore. I know it's a little bit more laborious not to, but I don't. And it's because of the texture that you need to get in the dough. And I'll show you as we go along. This dough, really simple. Here I have plain flour, or all-purpose flour if you want to call it that. There is 325 grams of flour in here, and I'm just going to pop that into my bowl in front of me. To that I add 1 tablespoon, and I'm going to use caster sugar. You could use normal granulated sugar if you want to, but I like caster sugar, so I've just got 1 tablespoon here, which is 15 mil of caster sugar. That goes in there. Then we add a very fine sea salt, and I have this fine crystal sea salt here. If you want something a little bit coarser, and I also use a kosher salt as well, if you want something a little bit coarser, you might have to add a little bit more to the actual recipe for this dough. It all depends on your taste, but I am going to do 1 teaspoon of this fine sea salt. That goes in. Then the most important thing that goes in here, let me take my watch off. The most important thing that goes in here is the butter. And I'm just going to start chopping it here because I just got it out of the fridge. The key to making a really, really good dough is you need cold butter. If your butter starts to warm up, the dough goes all kind of gluggy, I suppose, and we lose what we should have, which is the pieces of butter kind of staying together. Let's just stir this around. All right. I've just looked. Look there. I've chopped the butter. This is 225 grams of unsalted butter. Right. That's it. You can get in there with your fingers if you wish to, but I've got this little gadget here. Actually, I wish it was a bit bigger. That would be good, because this is, I find that a little bit small. Anyhow, this is my gadget that I use, and I'm going to do it. Let's do it right in front of you here. So what we start doing is we start breaking this butter up into the flour, and, you know, this is the hardest work that you'll have to do in making this pie. is break this butter up into the flour. So let's get on with it. And what we're looking for is, we're looking for a texture. That's a bit noisy. I'll show you in a minute. The texture is that you want to have pieces of butter. You could even have pieces of butter that are like a pea size big, large size. And what happens is that makes a really beautiful flaky pastry because the air kind of gets trapped inside the butter and between the butter and the flour, and it kind of puffs up, and that's why you get this amazing pastry. So we're going to continue. Right, I'm going to show you the consistency of this. See it? So I have pieces in here that are even up to this big with butter. And that is what we want in a pastry. And that's why I don't use a food processor anymore, because that is the consistency that I want. Okay, I'm going to go and get some water and we're going to finish this off. All right. Okay. Because we're so warm in here today, you might want to start putting this in and out of the fridge. Or if you've got a freezer nearby, you might want to be putting it in and out of the freezer as well. But preferably try to choose not such a hot day to make your pie. Who would have thought? Me, crazy me. All right, so what I've done is I've put a little bit of water in already and I've kind of mixed as much as I can. I don't want to overmix this this dough, because if you overmix it, why did we actually use the breaker upper for the butter? We may as well have done it in the food processor. So I had about 200 mil in here, or 200 grams, whatever, it's virtually the same. And so far I have used 100 mil in here. And I think usually in the winter I use a little bit more water. And I think it's because it is so warm in here today. I think we've got about 27 degrees, which is quite good. I mean, we've had a heat wave here in this country. And see, it's already come together. So no more water. I'm not going to use any more. Then let's just look at this here. I'm going to cut it in half. I'm not going to measure. I'm just going to cut it in half. Yeah. There we are. And that's it. Look how beautiful that is. That's your dough. All right. I am going to wrap these in a little bit of cling film or plastic or glad wrap if you're Australian, whatever you want to do. And just flatten them out a little bit so that they're in discs. And then I'm going to put it in the fridge and let this cool down. Probably about half an hour in the fridge. When I get it out, I'll show you the consistency of what it should look like. But at the moment, it's very squidgy. So I need to get this into the cold as soon as possible. Hi. Right. Okay. So while the pastry is in the fridge cooling down, I am going to make a very, very quick streusel to go on top of this pie. And when I say quick, I mean quick, because again, we're going to be using butter. and it's warm in the kitchen because now I have a pot of water on behind me because I'm making in the middle of making dinner. Right. So we're going to get on with this nice and quick. I have in this bowl, I have 50 grams of icing sugar, or if you want to call it confectioner's sugar. And that is in here. To that, I am going to put in a quarter of a teaspoon of baking powder. That goes in there. I'm going to put in a pinch of salt. Goes in there, mix that up a little bit. And then I am going to put in about, I'm going to do 4 tablespoons of plain flour. 2, 3, let's do a little bit more. Because it's warm today and because of the butter, I'm going to have to add a little bit more flour into this to get the consistency that I want. Here I have 60 grams of unsalted butter. Put that in there. Now I'm going to start breaking it up. I could use my little gadget again, but I'm not going to. I'm going to do this quickly with my fingers. Okay, my fingers are warm. So we need to do this quick. Quick, 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 quick. You could use a fork if you want to, but I actually find this much, much quicker to do. And again, we are looking for, I suppose it kind of looks like big porridge oats. That's what I'm looking for. This is going nice and quick. That flapping in the background is my galangal that I said would happen because it's really windy today. We've got the weirdest weather at the moment. It's a little bit like a kind of the weather that you get before a zombie apocalypse. Grey, a bit overcast, really hot. Then we get these really still moments. Oh boy, this is sticking to my fingers. Okay, let's go quick, girl. I might have to put this in the fridge, come back to it, cool my hands down. But actually, I think this is looking quite good. Fast, 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 fast work. We don't want this to melt at all. Okay, there it is. Very stuck to my fingers, but that's my streusel. Take all this off my fingers. Oh dear. Choose the hottest day to make a pie. Yay. Yay, yay, yay. I really needed to use these peaches up. All right, that's that done. Great, next step. All right, now that the dough has been in the fridge for, well, over half an hour, I thought I'd better give it a little bit longer. And I've put on a pinny, well, or an apron, if that's what you want to call it, because I do make quite a mess in the kitchen. And I go through t-shirts like you wouldn't believe. All right, yeah, I'm a pig. Right, I'm going to roll out this pastry. Sometimes I do it on greaseproof paper, but today I'm going to actually do it on my quartz because it is nice and cool and I want to get it done as fast as possible. This is my tin that I'm going to use. It's not one where the bottom comes out. It's actually a pie tin without springform. And it is about 10 inches in diameter. What's 10 inches in? Look, I have my trusty 25 centimeters in diameter. Yeah. I put a little bit of baking paper on the bottom just in case, you never know. And then all I do is just get a little bit of butter and smear it around there. The key to rolling out this pastry is flour, 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 flour. And if you think you haven't got enough flour, put more flour because you are there. It will probably stick at some point in time to the surface of whatever you do it on. I'm using my little bread scraper thing and I'm just going to go to the fridge, which is just over there, and get this pastry out. I didn't want to get it out too early because, like I said, it's quite warm here today. Remember, I divided this in half, this pastry. Well, I'm going to use a half for the base of this pie. It is, oh, it's still quite soft in the middle, which is quite amazing. Right, let's get going. Lots and lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of flour. A lot of people freak out when they start working with pastry because as soon as something sticks, that's when you kind of think, ah, that's it. It's ruined, but it's not. And don't worry if you put lots and lots of flour on this pastry because you can always brush it off, which is fine. So your guess now is a 10-inch diameter tin. And the sides on this one are about, oh, let's say another 2 inches. Okay, so we're looking for about a foot. We're looking for about 12 inches. You can use your tape measure. You can use a ruler if you want to. I know that my splatter thingy that I use here is about 13 inches. I know that already, and so I use this quite a lot for when I'm doing pies and, you know, quiches and stuff like that. Look how this starts rolling out beautifully. If you find that you are starting to stick, that this is where this comes in. You can actually lift and put the flour underneath if you want to, because, you know, 9 times out of 10, it is going to stick. It's got a lot of butter in this, remember? We're got a funny looking square at the moment, but it is rolling out beautifully. When I line this, okay, now I need to really check that we're not, see, we're starting to stick. See, that broke. Okay, flour, 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 and patch up. That's all you do. Flour and patch up. Let's go on this side. Lift and more flour. I'm not going to turn this anymore because I think I'm going to have a disaster if I turn. More flour. Here we are. Good. Okay. Let's keep going. Never seen me work so fast. Oh dear. If you find that it does start to get too hot, all you've got to do is lever this somehow onto a tray. How's that looking? That's nearly there, I reckon. And pop it back in the freezer or back in the fridge. All right, bye. You can go. Right, this is how I do it. You can fold. Actually, folding's quite a good idea too, but I'm not going to. Let's see how we go with the old rolling it on the rolling pin. It's very flaky. Lots of flour on the bottom. Few cracks. I don't really care because this is going to be covered. There we are. I'm rolling it beautifully. On you go. And in you go. And I've shown you how to do this before, actually. So what I do is, as soon as that goes in like that, I then fold everything in on itself. The whole lot. Otherwise, what you're going to start to do is you're going to start to see tears happening. So that is all folded in. Okay? Then I start unfolding, but I'm pressing down at the same time. So we're just unfolding. I'm pressing right into the corners. What a beautiful pastry. Do a little bit of a patch up there. There, there, double fold that one. It's a bit thicker. And then if you want to, if you want to have thicker sides, you can actually pull some pieces off and get just a little bit of water or milk if you want to. Just brush it on and stick the extra bits on. See, I've got a little bit there. You can just see here. There's a little bit of tin showing. So what I'm going to do is I've actually doubled up here. I'm just going to press that on. Okay, this is looking great. Okay, this goes back in the fridge, or you can pop it in the freezer if you want to. I'm not really pushed for time, so I'm going to put this back in the fridge and see how it goes. And if that doesn't work, it'll go back, it'll go into the freezer for a little bit. You want this more or less to be rock hard. Not frozen, of course, but rock hard. All right? Great. All right, I've got my pie dough out of the, pastry dough out of the fridge. And I'm just lining it now with a little bit of foil, with some aluminium foil. And I am going to blind bake this for a little bit. You could put it in just like that if you want to be a little bit lazy, But I have some beans that I always put inside. As soon as they're done, I put them back in the jar when they're cooled down, and I use this every single time. Just to weight it down, really. Okay, you can use rice. A lot of people use rice as well, but I'm gonna use these beans. They're just a mix of whatever dried beans I had around the house. I have preheated the oven too. I use a fan oven, and it is on 180. If you use a normal oven, it's 200 Celsius, or if you're working in Fahrenheit, it's 400 Fahrenheit, okay? This is gonna go in now for 10 minutes. There we are, 10 minutes, I'll see you then. So that was 10 minutes in the oven, and I am just going to get this pie base here. It is quite hot. Leave this stuff out, and I'm just going to pop it in this bowl just so that it will cool down. This is what you're looking at here. We've got a little bit of a soggy bottom happening at the moment, but I am going to put this back into the oven for about another, well, I'm going to check it 5 minutes. Gosh, look how filthy these are. I'm going to check it 5 minutes, and then at 8, and then if we have to, 10 minutes. And I just want this to go golden. There we are. That's back in the oven. Same temperature. Right, everybody. Here is my pie base. Lightly golden, not too many bubbles in the bottom, which is really, really good. And I'm just going to stick it on the top of the hob here, or on the top of the stove, while it just cools down a little bit. While it's cooling down, let's swap this over. I have a bowl, and here are my peaches. Like I said to you, they're really, really ripe, which is fabulous. And you can see this little cheese, everybody. It's that it's taken me this long to cook this pie. It's now evening. Right, let's talk about peaches. These are the orange flesh, or yellow flesh, if you want to call them. You can also get white fleshed peaches, but not so much here in the UK. And I always hope when I cut into a peach that it's going to be what I call clingless, so it's not clinging to the stone. And when I cut into this one here, all I do is twist, and there we are. It's a clingless. And actually, all of these peaches, and I think it was because they were really, really ripe, were clingless. So that's it. I have quartered all these peaches here. Here's my tea towel. I have about a pound and a half of peaches. And when I think about what is a pound and a half of peaches, it's funny, isn't it? Because I do metric, and I also do old fashioned as well. It was about 5 peaches altogether. So if you've got scales that do, grams and also pounds and ounces, then you can always, you know, go from one to another, and that's what I did. I will check in a minute and see how much a pound and a half is in grams and grams. And everyone is yelling at me now on the screen exactly what that is. But I will check. So there are my peaches. To this, I am going to add granulated sugar. You know how before I used caster sugar for my pastry? This time I'm using granulated. Now, if you don't want too sweet a pie, put in 2 tablespoons. I'm somewhere in the middle. These are very sweet, so I'm gonna put 3 tablespoons in. But if your peaches aren't very flavorful, then you can put in 4 tablespoons. And with my hands, I'm gonna give this a little mix in this bowl with this lovely sugar, and then I'm going to let this stand for 10 minutes or so. Here we are. Let me wash my hands. I'm also preparing dinner at the same time, so I've just done pasta. I'm going to do a pasta salad. Mr. N fancied a pasta salad. All right, so that's 10 minutes. I'm going to have a little slurp and I'll see you for the next step. All right, we're on the second last step really to this pie. I've just taken my streusel out of the fridge and here I have creme fraiche. I like the full fat. I never cook with skinny or half fat creme fraiche. And I'm going to put in this cooled down tart tin, I'm going to put 2 tablespoons of creme fraiche and spread it on the bottom of this tart or pie base. There it is. Just pop that there. Then I'm just going to get a handful of streusel. Of course, this is just for us, so I can use my hands. There we are, a little bit more. You can see just there, covered it. And all the peaches that had the sugar on are now going in. I was just going to throw them in, but I won't. I am going to lay them very nicely. I'm going to fan them out nicely in here, for the bottom layer anyhow. And then we'll put one or two in the middle here. And then I'll go the opposite direction, like that, you can make it as pretty as you want, like that, a bit more there, another one there, oh, that smells fantastic. When you put sugar on fruit like this, delish, there we are, that's it, that is all of the peaches. To that, I now put dollop some creme fraiche on top. I'm going to use another 2 tablespoons and dollop it on top. Dollop, dollop, all over. Ooh, that's very nice. You could use a bit more. I might do it a little bit more. It's a little bit luxurious. That goes in there. Let me just wash my hands quickly. Some water here. And the last of the streusel over the top. This is beautiful stuff. I love anything with streusel. I think it's my kind of Germanic upbringing that I had. Streusel is wonderful. There we go. That's it. Doesn't look like much, but it is. Peach pie with streusel. Okay, this has gone into an oven now. I have reduced the heat on this oven to 170 fan, which is 190 normal oven, which is 375 Fahrenheit. And this is going in here for about 50 minutes. If you find that the outside of the crust of the pie starts to get a little bit too brown, you can put some foil on that and that will stop it getting brown. So this is going in for 50 minutes. I cannot wait for that. Here is the finished product. Yummy! And I've cut myself a piece. I'm not a big kind of pudding eater, actually. I would eat this for breakfast. Wow. That's absolutely beautiful. I'm going to go and give it to Mr. N because he is a pudding eater. So there you go. Beautiful peach pie with a bit of creme fraiche and some streusel as well. And I hope you make it because it is absolutely fabulous. I will see you next time. Hopefully not in a few months' time. See you later. And if you also want to subscribe, please subscribe and give me a thumbs up. Bye.
What's in season? What's